Hello everybody, this is a Punk, Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Mega Man 8 playthrough. Welcome back indeed, because in our last episode, which was over a month ago at the time of this recording, we made it through Wily Tower Stage 3, where we took on boss battles against Bass and the Green Devil. And again, more than a month since that last episode, it is finally time to conclude this playthrough. There's only one stage left in Wily Tower, and by extension, the entire game. It is time for Wily Stage 4, which will feature the final boss. So, let's go ahead and get started. Alright everybody, it is indeed go time! It is time for Wily Stage 4, the final level of the game, and if you know anything at all about classic Mega Man, or really the Mega Man franchise in general, you'll know what's coming when you start the level. It is time for the obligatory boss rush, that classic staple of Mega Man tradition, where before you have a chance to face the final boss, you must defeat all 8 Robot Masters in a row, in one run, in order to gain access to the actual final boss. And for the Robot Masters, since you've already defeated them previously, you'll have access to all of their weaknesses, so you can just use them to your advantage. Or if you're the guy who likes a challenge, you can just use your Mega Buster on all of them, which I am not good enough at this game to even attempt. Now, one note to make here about the boss rush for this game is that once you defeat a Robot Master, they will drop a large health item, and you actually have a small window in which to grab that item. Be sure to pick it up, especially if you take a lot of damage in a given battle, because all the damage you take from a given battle will carry over into the next one, and of course that will add up over time. So once you see that health item drop, grab it. You really don't want to spend too much time having to redo the boss rush. Basically, if you're like me and you like to grind up your extra lives, be sure to save those extra lives for the actual encounter with Wily. So here we go here, and you're going to see from some of the footage here, especially here against Tengu Man, if you can see it at 400% speed, is that I am a bit out of practice here with this game. Like I said, there was a month-long gap between episodes here, and most of it is tied to my frustration from dealing with the final boss of the game. Originally, I had intended to record all of Wily Tower in one run, and I got most of it done in a live recording. But unfortunately, when I got to Wily and actually had to fight his machine, I was just dying so much, and I was just getting so frustrated, and I was already burned out from doing the rest of Wily Tower previously. So I basically dropped the game for a while, and I meant to return to this game and finish it much, much sooner. But unfortunately, I started playing different games, I had other commitments outside of YouTube, in real life, like having an actual job now. So I just found myself putting off Mega Man 8 until finally I got myself to sit down and I was like, I'm gonna sit down and I'm going to beat this game. Which results in the footage that you are seeing now for the playthrough. Anyway, once you beat all the Robot Masters in the boss rush, you will finally be able to proceed. Be sure to break that party ball type item so you can get an item that will fully replenish all of your weapons. Because trust me, if you're going by weakness, you might find yourself using up your weapon energy quite a bit. And you're going to need all the weapon energy you can get if you're going for weaknesses against Wily here. But before you can face the Doctor, we have ourselves a little bit more story development, and Dr. Wily is going to ambush Mega Man. Somehow I think he should have expected that. And of course, Wily's going to drop in with his machine. This is Wily Machine 8. And I'm not liking the look of that gun mounted on the front of it. That looks like it's going to hurt if he manages to nail Mega Man with it. So this is definitely looking like a rather dire situation for our blue bomber buddy. But, wait for it. Wait for it. It's our buddy Duo. Remember him? He's only the character that was introduced in this game. He's gonna swoop in and be the hero and take out the gun mounted on the Wily machine. The problem is, that's about the only contribution he's going to make for us in this situation, but at least he makes the final boss possible. Unfortunately, it would have been nice if he had, I don't know, destroyed the rest of Wily Machine along with the gun. Probably could have made the ensuing battle a little bit more bearable. But you can't always get what you want, am I right? And then, of course, Proto Man decides to drop in for a little interlude. You know, Proto Man, you also could have made yourself more useful throughout our adventure, but at least he's going to get Duo out of the way. And it's the moment we've been waiting for, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for the hero to finally take on the villain. It's Mega Man versus Wily, Part 8. You know, since this is the 8th main Mega Man game. So Wily Machine 8 can be a rather formidable opponent to deal with. The main attack, or the main part of the machine you'll want to worry about, there's two of them. There's the wheel mounted on the side, which has a cannon that will shoot either purple orbs or blue orbs. It will also break off of the machine and basically try to attack you directly. It'll either travel along the ground or it will actually bounce. I have no way of telling which attack it's going to use, so you do see me fall victim to the rolling wheel repeatedly. There's also a gun mounted inside the mouth of the Wily machine, and you will want to disrupt the charge of that gun so that it doesn't attack you as well. Now, the weaknesses, according to what I've read, are primarily the water balloon and the flash bomb. But, as you saw during that first attempt, I basically decided to throw caution to the wind, get right up in Wily's face, and spam the flame sword. This is actually a strategy I picked up from watching a different YouTube video of this boss fight. And although I did die on that first attempt, it was actually proving to be somewhat effective. You know, basically just get in Wily's face with the flame sword and just attack, attack, attack. It does make it a little harder to dodge the attacks more effectively, you know, going with this kind of approach. It's pretty much all attack, no defense. But as you can see, I am whittling away at his health pretty efficiently here. And I actually am going to defeat him on this attempt, taking a few more unnecessary hits in the process. But ultimately, I am going to knock off Wily Machine 8 right about now. Now, unfortunately, that's not the end of your struggle. If anything, the real struggle is about to begin, because now it's time for the Wily Capsule. I believe the Wily Capsule was introduced in Mega Man 5, and the Wily Capsule is basically the second half of the final boss. Maybe even you could say the true final boss after beating the Wily Machine. And this thing was a terror for me when I first encountered it. This was the boss that turned me off of the game and kept me from completing it for so long. The thing is that he can be out of reach of some of your attacks. The two primary weaknesses, according to what I've read for the Wily Capsule, there is the Flash Bomb and the Flame Sword. I would recommend going with the Flash Bomb, because there are going to be some situations where it'll be impossible to reach him with the Flame Sword, in addition to the fact that you have to get close in order to attack him. And, you know, I was able to tank the Wily Machine's attacks and, you know, kill him with the Flame Sword. But here, you definitely want to be more focused on avoiding the Wily Capsule's attacks and trying to retain as much HP as possible in order to be able to take this thing out. This is definitely the... I mean, it's a final boss, all right. This is definitely the toughest boss encounter out of the entire game, which is totally reasonable to expect. I mean, it is the final boss. And another handicap, if you will, that you're going to have to overcome is the fact that if you die against the Wily capsule, you have to face the Wily machine again. So as you can tell by my life counter, if you give it a good look, I died quite a few times to the Wily capsule in the process of trying to defeat it. Luckily, I did not get a game over, so I avoided that, but definitely, this was definitely a situation where I had to just suck it up. Like, I knew that the only way to beat the game was to get past this boss. I couldn't, you know, get out of fighting it, so I just had to suck it up and just keep at it. That was just basically what I had to do. Just keep at it, keep fighting him, and, like, as I fought him more and more, I got closer and closer to beating him, and I'll admit, my confidence did begin to pick up. I began to better anticipate what kind of attack he was going to do. I was, getting more knowledgeable of his tells, what kind of attacks he was using with the purple orbs so I could more effectively dodge them. I was taking advantage of my rush items to help recover my health and weapon energy. And really, it was just, I was learning as I went, basically. But really, the best way for me to fight this guy is to use the flash bomb in combination with charged buster shots. Basically, just alternate between those two weapons and you should be in good shape. A good thing to do is to try to be on the opposite side of the arena from him, so you'll be able to better anticipate the purple orbs and react accordingly so that you can dodge them. The most annoying purple orbs are that attack right there, where they basically try to home in on you, a cluster of four purple orbs. They're surprisingly hard to avoid. But anyway, best advice I can give, you know, use the flash bomb combined with the charged buster, stay on the opposite side of the arena so you can best anticipate the purple orbs, and just keep at it. Don't get discouraged if you die a few times. You will eventually get him. Much like I did right here. And of course, we have the classic scene of Wily suddenly begging for forgiveness because he knows he's screwed. And of course, Mega Man is having none of it. But unfortunately, before we can lay the finishing blow, we're about to get disrupted.
This is not good. He's been affected by the evil energy. He will die soon. If your mind is not completely taken by the evil, you'll be saved. Mega Man, I can see into your mind. been working so hard for justice. With your help, this planet will survive.
What happened, Mega Man?
He's going to be okay. He will regain consciousness soon. My job is done. I must go. I'll leave Mega Man up to you. But there's one more thing. I have a favor to ask.
Duo is gone.
Proto Man!
Mega Man, I have a message to give you from Duo.
From Duo? What is it?
He said, thank you.
Duo? Me too. Thank you, Duo.
And with that final cutscene, ladies and gentlemen, that is the conclusion of Mega Man 8. And boy, was I happy to see this credit sequence when I finally beat Wily Capsule. Although, before we get to the actual credits, we actually see something that I find personally very interesting. We actually get to see what were basically concepts of the 8 Robot Masters featured in this game. It's actually pretty interesting. Back in the day for classic Mega Man, at least for some games in the series, they actually had people submit their own drawings, their own concepts for Robot Masters, and then those concepts would be adapted into the Robot Masters that would ultimately be featured in the game, such as this one. And what's interesting is that, trying to remember based on some reading I did a while ago, for Mega Man 8, not only did they have people submit concepts, they actually had concepts based on specific ideas. Like, for example, Clown Man, what ultimately became Clown Man, was centered around a Robot Master with long arms. And let's see here. I believe for Search Man, it had to be a Robot Master with two heads, things of that nature. And I have to say, you know, it's a shame that, you know, I mean, obviously over here in America, you know, I don't think there was really anything like that with a game being developed. And if you ask me, that would be a heck of a thing to be able to brag about, especially if you were a kid and you wanted to, you know, talk about how cool you were on the playground. I mean, I would love to be able to say, my concept for a Robot Master was used in Mega Man. I mean, that would be a heck of a thing to brag about if you ask me. But who knows, maybe I'm a weird person, I'm not sure. And what's interesting here is that as we go through the actual credits, I'm guessing what we see here with these other drawings is that these were other submissions for Robot Masters that ultimately ended up being rejected, and some of them are pretty interesting designs, to say the least. But anyway, I did speak about the frustration I had dealing with the Wily Capsule, and that's why it took so long for this video to get done. And I have to say, looking back, it was a bit of a shame that I didn't do a live commentary recording, because when I finally beat that Wily Capsule, it was such a feeling of elation and accomplishment. It felt so good when I finally defeated that Wily capsule, I was just like, yes, I am going to finish this game. It's finally going to be complete. And I guess at this point, since we're at the end of the playthrough, it's time for some final thoughts regarding the game. I did enjoy, ultimately, putting together this playthrough. Again, there were some difficulties, obviously, with the final boss. And I guess if there were some things I could have done differently, I wish I could have put in some more practice for some of the Wily stages. Like, looking back, I feel that my battles against Bass and the Green Devil in Wily Stage 3, I feel like those recordings were a bit sloppy. And obviously the big regret is that I wish I hadn't taken a month, more than a month, between the last episode and this one. But all the same, it feels good to finally be done with this playthrough. And it's good. It was good to return to Classic Mega Man, because the last time I featured a Classic Mega Man game on my YouTube channel was Mega Man 2 back in 2013 under my old Ultimate Lifeform RB name. And so under the new Punk Demon Neo name, I decided it was time to come back to Classic Mega Man. And as I explained at the very beginning of this playthrough, the reason I went with Mega Man 8 is because Mega Man 8 was the first Mega Man game I ever saw. It was the first one I ever played. And I am glad that I was finally able to cover it for the channel, as we have this nice little image at the end of the credits. Thank you for playing, presented by Capcom. And I guess, as we conclude the final thoughts segment, I have made references to the fact that this playthrough was done using the PlayStation 1 version. There is the Saturn version for the game, and as I've talked about, the Saturn version does have content that is not present in the PlayStation version. I've talked about different music tracks. There are the two extra bosses, Cutman and Woodman. And basically, like I said, I'm not going to be able to feature any of those because I don't own a Sega Saturn, nor do I own the Saturn version of this game. And also, there are actually some extra features in the Saturn version. There are like art galleries and stuff like that, which are also not present in the PlayStation 1 version. Unfortunately, I will not be able to feature any of that content. But all the same, I feel like I was able to deliver as close to a complete playthrough as I could, given the version of the game I was playing. And it does feel good to finally be done with this game so I can move on to my next project. As for what I'm going to do to follow up this game, I'm not quite sure yet, but I have announced a playthrough for the original Super Nintendo Star Fox game, which will be a follow-up to my Pikmin playthrough that I recently finished. And if you're interested in seeing the finale for the Pikmin playthrough, I would greatly appreciate it if you would check that out. But having said that, I think it's time to wrap things up here. So that is the conclusion of the Mega Man 8 playthrough. If you folks enjoyed this playthrough, be sure to let me know. If you enjoyed this video specifically, be sure to leave a like and leave a comment. Tell me what you think. Subscribe to support the channel if you haven't already. And be sure to click the notify button when you subscribe so you'll actually be notified when I post something. Having said all that, one more thing to add is that if you would like to see me return and play any of the other classic Mega Man games, be sure to let me know, because I'm certainly open to it in the future. Although at this point, if I'm going to do any more Mega Man games, I'm actually planning on returning to the X series, and I might do Mega Man X4 next, but we'll see what happens in the future. In any case, that's going to do it for this video. That's going to conclude this playthrough. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now, and I hope to see you in the next video.